Hi, this is Matt King.
And Carly Lau, and today we are going to be talking about detection methods for the eastern indigo snake, dry marchand couperi.
The eastern indigo snake is an apex predator occurring in the southeastern United States. It's currently listed as federally threatened because of mortalities associated with human activity. In order to conserve this species, scientists need to locate individuals in order to answer important research questions.
The issue that we are going to be addressing today is that it is very difficult to detect these snakes for multiple reasons. Little is known about their life history, they occur at low population numbers and densities, and they are very cryptic in nature.
We will discuss and compare three methods to detect indigo snakes in the wild. Afterwards, we'll give a recommendation based on the following criteria: time, cost, and effectiveness.
The first method to detect and capture indigo snakes is the use of drift fences into a box trap. Eastern indigo snakes take refuge in gopher tortoise burrows, which is utilized in all of the following detection methods. This method uses drift fences outside of the burrow entrance, leading to the box trap. As you can see on the slides, trap designs mostly involve short fences that funnel the snake into the entrance of the box trap. Illustrated in the bottom left picture, you can see the boxes have small holes that allow entrance into the box, but they cannot exit.
One benefit of this method is that it can reduce the amount of time researchers spend in the field. It also requires little previous experience with indigo snakes. A downside to this method is that it takes significant time and resources to construct or purchase the box traps. Additionally, this technique was less time effective at capturing indigo snakes compared to other methods. In one study, it took an average of 27 man hours per capture. This includes construction time and field hours. This method was also less effective at capturing individuals compared to our other two methods.
The most common technique used to detect indigo snakes is by pedestrian survey. This method is often completed by walking to gopher tortoise burrows and looking for the snakes inside. It can also be done by having trained surveyors walk transects in designated areas and record either sheds or live snakes. A benefit of this method is that it is more effective and time efficient compared to the previous method. One study detected 18 individuals this way, with an average of 14 hours per snake. One drawback to this method is that it still takes long periods of field work. In addition, surveyors need extensive experience and knowledge of indigo snake behavior to correctly locate the individuals.
Our final method to detect indigo snakes is by using detection dogs. This is a newer method for eastern indigo snakes, but has been successfully used on other snake species. Detection dogs can be trained to identify both live snakes and their shedded skin. Dog handlers will walk transects in study areas and have the dog cue when they smell an indigo snake. One study found that the trained dogs can detect the live snakes both above ground and in the gopher tortoise burrows.
There are many benefits to this method as it is time efficient since dogs can cover more ground than pedestrians. This also makes it more cost effective because less time is spent in the field. In studies using dogs, they were able to detect snake skins that human observers missed. Additionally, they had higher detection rate overall compared to the human observer. One trial found that the dogs located 81% of live snakes and 100% of sheds. The negative to this method is that the use of dogs takes extensive training and specific weather conditions can impede the dog smelling accuracy. It is also important to consider that this is a new method and has not had many replications.
Considering the criteria of cost, time, and effectiveness, we suggest that the best method for locating eastern indigo snakes is detection dogs. Overall, the cost of dogs is low compared to traps, and it's less costly than pedestrian surveys because it decreases man hours. The use of dogs is the most effective method because the dogs detected more snakes and sheds than humans could. Studies with traps captured less snakes than the dogs located.
We would like to thank all the authors of the literature that contributed to our evaluation.
Please leave any questions in the comment section, and we are looking forward to getting back to you.
Thanks for watching.